वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल रिज्यूम नाउ रीडिंग द चैप्टर 3 विजन्स फॉर इंडिया. इन द फर्स्ट वीडियो वी हैव सीन व्हाट वर द फर्स्ट 2 विजन्स ऑफ डॉक्टर APJ अब्दुल कलाम, एंड नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट ही हैज़ गॉट टू से रिगार्डिंग थर्ड विजन. लेट्स बिगिन द रीडिंग. आई हैव अ थर्ड विजन दैट इंडिया मस्ट स्टैंड अप टू द वर्ल्ड और no one will respect us. Only strength respects strength. We must be strong not only as a military power but also as an economic power. Both must go hand in hand. Why are we in India so embarrassed to recognize our own strength, our achievements? We are such a great nation. We have so many amazing success stories, but we refuse to acknowledge them. Why? We are the second largest producer of wheat in the world. We are the second largest producer of rice. We are the first in milk production. We are number one in remote sensing satellites. Look at Dr. Sudarshan. He has transferred the tribal village into a self-sustaining, self-driving unit. There are millions of such achievements, but our media is obsessed only with bad news and failures and disasters. Now let us try and understand what Dr. Kalam says in this paragraph. To stand up means to have self-respect and face the challenges and to face the world bravely. He says that only strength respects strength. What does that mean? This means that if you're weak, then definitely someone will dominate you. So, if you want respect from someone else, you should have strength. Strength of what type? Both economic power, strength of economic power as well as military power. Military power means a strong base of armed forces for the defense of our country, to protect our country in case of, you know, any attack from outsider. And not only that, he says that we should have economic power also. He says that both should go hand in hand, means we should have both the types of powers. Now what do you mean by economic power? Economic power is the power to take decision of production, distribution, consumption, the way we want. When we are strong economically, we can take all these decisions and which will benefit ourselves, and it does not allow then any other giant country to interfere with our decisions. Now here he also mentions Dr. Sudarshan. He says he has made a tribal village into a self-sustaining and self-driving unit. What do you mean by self-sustaining? This means that the village has the power and the capacity to provide for its own needs. It is not dependent on anyone, and it is a self-driving unit. Meaning what? I'm sure all of you must have heard about driverless cars. What are they? They don't need any driver to take them forward. So in the same manner, self-driving unit meaning what? They don't need any outside force to take the village ahead. They have got the capacity to go ahead without anybody's help. Okay. I hope you have understood this point. He also says that we have got millions of achievements, but we are embarrassed, we are ashamed, we are not proud of them. Why should we be ashamed of recognizing our strength or achievements? So he says, you know, our media is only obsessed. Obsessed with means what? Intensely occupied with some particular emotion. So he says our media is only obsessed with bad things, failures, disasters, and does not concentrate or does not focus on good things. I'm sure all of you all must be knowing that media means the means of communication such as, you know, radio, TV, films, etc. To reach out to a large number of people. So he says there should be a change in the way our media is addressing things. There should be a change from bad things to good things. And in the end he asks, Do we not realize that self-respect comes with self-reliance? So you see, this is the same thing what our Modi ji is talking about. Self-reliance means becoming Atmanirbhar. Atmanirbhar meaning what? Kisi pe bhi depend nahi karna. Even Dr. Kalam is saying the same thing. That you want respect, then you have to become self-reliant. Don't depend on anyone for anything. Now let's read ahead. I was in Tel Aviv once and I was reading the Israeli newspaper. It was the day after a lot of attacks and bombardments and deaths had taken place. The Hamas had struck. But the front page of the newspaper had the picture of a Jewish gentleman who in 5 years had transformed his desert land into an orchid farm and granary. It was this inspiring picture that everyone woke up to. The gory details of killings, bombardments and deaths were inside the newspaper, buried among other news. Isn't it possible in our country? So you see, Dr. Kalam is narrating his experience in Israel. He had visited and there, you know, a militant organization had struck and there was a lot of, you know, bombardment, death on the earlier day. But when he opened the newspaper the next day, what was the front picture? Front picture was a Jewish gentleman who had transformed his desert land. You know, desert land, I don't need to explain, where rainfall is very less and hardly anything can grow. Such kind of land he had transformed into an orchid farm and granary. So isn't it a very positive news that everybody must have got the very first day, I mean on the very first page? It is not that other things were not given by the paper. The news regarding killings, bombardment, death, everything was there. It was not hidden, but it was inside. You know, the main thing that everybody will wake up to, the first thing that will there everybody will see was a very positive thing. So he says, this kind of approach, this kind of attitude should be adopted even in our country. Focus, concentrate on positive things. Now let's read the concluding part of the chapter. Another question. Why are we as a nation so obsessed with foreign things? We want foreign TVs, we want foreign shirts, we want foreign technology. Why this obsession with everything imported? Do we not realize that self-respect comes with self-reliance? I was in Hyderabad giving this lecture when a 14-year-old girl asked me for my autograph. I asked her what her goal in life is. She replied, I want to live in a developed India. For her, you and I will have to build this developed India. You must proclaim. So you see, in the concluding part of the chapter, Dr. Kalam is again harping, again talking about the same point, Atmanirbhar Bharat. That is, he is saying that self-respect will only come when we are self-reliant. When we are dependent on others, the other is going to take, undue advantage. Then we'll have to bow in front of them. When we are dependent on them, no self-respect. So he says, learn. If you want respect, you have to be self-reliant. He says, forget why you have got to have so much strong emotions about foreign TV, foreign technology, foreign shirts. We boast, you know, I'm wearing this brand which is from America. Why? Why such strong feelings for imported things? Why don't we have such feelings for Indian things? So he is harping again and again talking about the same point. Then he is saying, one girl was asking his autograph in Hyderabad. When he asked her what her goal in life was, she says, I want to live in a developed India. Now she is a representative of the young generation of India. The 14-year-old old girl actually represents the future of India. So he says, for her and for every other person who is going to be the future of India, we must build, you and I, we have to build this developed India. And you must proclaim, means you have to make an announcement, official announcement, that yes, we will build such developed India where all this young generation can live. Students, let's now do the workshop questions. Question number 1. Complete Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam's profile with information from the lesson. Title: Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Profession: Missile Scientist. Branch of Science: Physics and Aerospace Engineering. Important position in government held: President of India. His 3 visions for India: freedom, development, and standing up to the rest of the world. Going over to the second question, note down the main differences between the following: a developing nation and a developed nation. You know, there may be many more points, I am just giving you one. A developed nation has high per capita income and GDP, whereas a developing nation has per capita income and GDP which is comparatively low. Next is self-reliant and self-assured. Self-reliant means not needing any support or help from others, and self-assured means having confidence in one's own self. Strengths and achievements. Our strengths are the abilities and qualities which we have, which we can use to our advantage for becoming successful. And our achievements are our successes or our accomplishments. Next is farm and granary. A farm is a large area of land used for growing crops or flowers, etc. And a granary is a storehouse for grains. Next is remote sensing satellite and natural satellite. A remote sensing satellite is a man-made satellite with remote sensors which has been launched into space to measure various things or to record various things. Whereas a natural satellite is any celestial body in space that orbits around a large body. Now going over to the third question, find evidence from the lesson and write in your own words. Indians respect the freedom of others. What can we write for this? India has not tried to conquer anyone or grab their land, culture and history. We have not tried to force our way of life on anyone. This is because Indians respect the freedom of others. Let's take the next sentence and see what we can write about it. It is time to see ourselves as a developed nation. We have been a developing country for 50 years. Now, we are among the top 5 nations of the world in terms of GDP. We have 10% growth rate in most areas. Our poverty levels are falling and our achievements are being recognized worldwide. It is time to see ourselves as a developed nation. So you see, in the same manner, you can write for C, D, E. That is a homework for you. Now let's go over to question number 4. Pick out some sentences from the lesson that convey a general truth. General truth meaning some sentences which give a truth which is general and not only true in the context of this particular chapter. For example, this one has been given to us: if we are not free, no one will respect us. On the same lines, let us see if we can find out other sentences. One is this: only strength respects strength. Second is: military power and economic power both must go hand in hand. And one more: self-respect comes with self-reliance. There may be many more such sentences which you are welcome to write, my dear students. And last but not the least, try and read the autobiography of Dr. Kalam, which goes by the name Wings of Fire. Thank you.